Hello everybody, what's up? This is Mehdi from GR Tutorial Studio, and today I want to show you how to create your own text effect and text animation in After Effects. It's really easy and fun, you just need to play with your text and keyframe. Now, if you're ready, let's get started. The first step is to type your text. Now, if you look at the timeline panel, and the text layer, you will see a section called text. Today, we are going to talk about this section and examine its various capabilities. Here is an animation menu with which we can create very different and attractive animation for our text. Let's start with opacity. You can see that has created a new section for us here called animator 1. Through this new section, you can control the opacity animation. Here we have a controller for opacity. Note that this opacity differs from the original opacity of the layer in the transform section. Now, you can see the opacity of the layer in the transform section, and as you can see, its value is set to 100. In the animator 1 section, set the opacity value to 0. And in the ram selector 1, we have three options, start, end, and offset. Now, for a start, we create a keyframe at the beginning of the timeline and set its value to 0. Then, go a little further in the 5 seconds. We create another keyframe and set the start value to 100. Now, we can create a simple animation in which the text appears slowly. There are many options in the advanced section, some of which I will explain later. But for now, I want to talk about smoothness. The smoothness value is set to 100 by default, and you can see that each letter appears smoothly. Now, I change its value and set it to 0. As you can see, the letters appear one by one, much like typing. Now, let me change the text. In the advanced section, the based on menu is set to character mode. In this case, the animation is executed for each letter. I set it to word mode. As you can see, the animation runs for each word. Now I want to make this text effect a little more attractive and add position animation on it. To do this, select animator 1 and select the position option from the animation menu. Note that you must have selected animator 1, otherwise it will create a new animator for you. You can also use the add menu versus animator 1. Now set the position value and I move the text a little upper and set the keyframes to easy ease. Then let me reset the smoothness value to 100 to see the effect better. This is really interesting. As you can see, there's a shape menu here. To explain it, let me set based on to character. Now, select the round option from the shape menu. You can see what happened. You can choose any of other shapes, for example, triangle or ramp up or other shapes. But for now, I want to add scale animation. I did this, then let me set based on to word. As easy as you saw, you need just to play with animator 1, for example, add more animation to your effect, create keyframe for different items, change the speed graph, and etc. You need just to play to create your own text effect. So, let me continue and create more effect together. I like it, but I want to create keyframes for blur. So, at the first, select blur option from the add menu and set its value on 30. Then, at the beginning of the timeline, I create a keyframe for star and set its value to 0. Then, I go to 2 seconds and create the second keyframe for star and I set the value on 100. Sounds great! Now, I want to create a keyframe for blur. So, at the beginning of the timeline, I create a keyframe for blur and set the value to remain at the same 30. Then, I go a little further and create the second keyframe and set the value to 0. I think it's better now, but it would be so much better if I made the keyframes easy ease. Now it's time to play with color. In the animation menu, there are two options for fill color and stroke color, each of which has different options. I choose the RGB option. You can choose whichever you like. Now I choose the color. Let's see the effect together. It may get better if I increase the blur value. Like I said, you just need to play with your animation and not worry at all. Whenever you are not satisfied with the animation you have created, you can easily delete it or reset its settings. To delete an animation, just select it and press the delete button. As easy as you saw. Now let's try another animation. So this time, select character offset. This animation is really interesting. I set the character offset value to 35. You can see the effect. Then, create those two keyframes for a start. Here in the advanced section, there are also settings for character alignment and character range that you can change. Now it's time for one of the very simple and attractive effects that I really like it. So if you're ready, let's go. This effect is not in the animation menu. It's here. To start, I make a keyframe at the beginning of the timeline. As you can see, our keyframes are hold. Let me play once and see what happens. You saw that when we got to the keyframes, the text changed automatically. You can change the font size, color, and etc. in each keyframe. For example, in the second keyframe, I changed the font and size. And now, I create a few more keyframes and change the text in each keyframe. Thanks for watching this video and I hope you enjoy watching it and it will be useful for you. And if you have any question, you can ask me. At the last, don't forget to like this video.